The ship.
We ain't found shit.
We ain't found garbage.
Arms day, baby. Want my ace of spades.
Ace or spades?
Yeah, there's, when you get
Skip-a-do-ba-do-ba.
the gunsmith to rank 3, he gives you a quest, and then he gives you a class-specific exotic primary weapon. And I have my Titan and my Warlock one, but I don't have my Hunters get a hand cannon called the Ace of Spades. I don't have it yet. But I'm rank 2, so I'm like, and I have all these weapons that I never tested, so I'm just like, oh, I should test these. I'm just doing
It
patrol.
is that is a doggy.
Doggy? Oh, my Disney Infinity figures I ordered are coming in today. Excited.
Oh.
My Poe and my Korra. Although the Korra's for Nicole. Here we go.
All right. Okie dokie, artichoke.
I don't see like any enemies. What the fuck? Where are they?
Okay. We all silent. Allan, I need you to say something.
Hello?
Okay, now I gotta wait for this video to catch up.
Wow, that's way behind.
I know. I think it might be because the app was still open when I was posting links. So I think it just paused the stream, and now it's just catching up. I'm gonna close it and then open it back up, but I figure I'll just wait. Actually, no. No, I won't.
Get spin metal. Zip a bop, dude.
Okay, say something else.
Are you talking to me?
Both of you.
Well, I'm talking now, so.
Yeah. What about
I'm talking now, too.
Fucking deal with it.
Alright, shush. Let me listen to this. Quality.
Okay.
Quality.
No, you won't. Credits will do fine.
Okay, good. Everybody
yeah,
can be heard.
Yeah, doing that to a Troidarian and KOTOR 2 and it didn't work.
I don't know what that means.
It didn't work. I've never played KOTOR 2. I own
you're,
it.
You're speaking a different language.
It's really good.
That's what everybody says. They say, oh, it's better than the
language.
First one.
Alright. That
I really
means
love
we're
the first one.
That means we are set. Oh man, that looks just spiffy. Welcome to Party Chat. This is our second episode. A streaming podcast. Yep. A streaming podcast on ToasterChimp. Today I'm joined with Josh Mobley. And I'm joined by DualShock's Allan Muir.
Hello.
Let me mess up this real quick. Hold on. I want to make sure that the audio is brought down.
Once like again, just like last episode, I'm just grinding out Grimoire cards.
That's alright.
Although, since the last time we talked, I have found all 115 ghosts in Destiny. I finally... Dude, that last one that I was trying to get last week, where you have to do the weird jumping behind the rocks to fucking get it, took me so long. It's the worst. It is like literally the worst one. It's so hard to get. It's that one they added, like recently. But yeah, I fucking, oh, it was so annoying. But once I got it, I was like, finally, God! And then I just left the strike. I didn't even help the people I was with finish the boss. I just left. I was like, I got what I came for.
That's such a dick.
Somebody else will queue in. They'll be fine.
What if that guy is a noob?
If you've never
I don't think
seen an
they were.
episode, shut up for a minute. It. If you've never seen an episode of
No.
Party Chat before, which wouldn't be hard because we've only had one,
Wouldn't be hard.
the idea is that we're just having a conversation while we're playing. We don't even have to be playing the same game. We're not.
Because we're not.
It's just the video's not even really important. It's not like we're talking about the game that is being played. We're just having a conversation. It's just something for you
What a
to
show!
It's just something for you to look at while you listen. So.
Oh man. Yeah. So, trying to think of like things that happened this week. I know there's like huge Destiny news.
I want to tell you something that I ran
Yeah, tell me
across.
something.
Well, first of all, we're joined by Allan
What
Mir.
if I don't give a shit?
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
And it's Allan's birthday today.
It is Allan's birthday today.
Happy birthday, sir.
Thank you, Skype.
Thank you,
For telling me.
Facebook. Thank
Yeah,
you, other
I
people in Slack.
don't take it as like a slight, Allan. I remember like probably four people's birthdays ever off the top of my head.
No, it's
One of
okay.
them is mine. So I rely heavily
He's
on
like,
things like Skype to tell me when it's people's
wait,
birthday.
when's my birthday?
I remember Matt's now because he told me like it's been encoded into his screen name, and now I'm like, oh, I'll always
Yeah.
remember now because it's there, I see it, you know. But yeah, most people I don't for instance, my father's birthday, couldn't fucking tell you. I'm 25 and I don't know what day my dad's birthday. I know it's like July something. That's about it.
It's something.
Yeah. This year, I couldn't remember if my mom's birthday was January 3rd or January 5th. Although I
Pretty
figured that out.
sure it's
I
the
asked.
third, right? Is it the third?
No, it's the 5th.
Damn it! Oh man, I really wanted to be the best. I really wanted to make it look like, you
The
know,
better relative?
I cared more than you did.
No, it's the 5th. But yeah, and I remember my sister's birthday because it's like 6 days before mine.
Yeah.
So yeah, yeah. Anyway, video games.
It doesn't have to be. Let's make something clear, all right? The conversation doesn't have to be about video games
Video games.
because I ran across a video thanks to Cracked. I don't know if you guys read Cracked regularly.
Not regularly. I actually watch their videos more than I
I
read them. I
usually
like their videos.
stop by every morning, just check out some of the articles that seem interesting to me.
As most people do.
And I don't remember what the article was, but there was
Oh, go, great.
they showed a video, and that's the point. They showed a video that was that was about these cyberpunks dancing to Thomas the Tank Engine.
What?
Obviously, the music is edited in, but
Oh.
it's just I'm like staring at them, like, how do these people wear these clothes? Like, have you
They all
seen?
look
And
like
like,
the Matrix.
no, they don't. They look so much
So they all
worse.
look like ner like they all look like Shadowrun Neuromancer people,
One
basically, is what
guy
they look like.
has. He looks like he's balding except for the back of his hair. Oh, shit. He
That
looks like he's.
happens, I think. Says me, I have no
So
fucking
he's
idea.
got this long hair, but like a giant forehead. it's long. It's kind of in a. It's like got half a ponytail, but not really. And it's got blue streaks in it, and he's holding a glow stick as he's like waving his arms around. And this other girl in fishnets is like
You
punching
got my attention.
the air.
Punching the air.
Yes.
So she's actively fighting her aggressors,
There's
who may or
one
may not be
guy
there.
in the background who's wearing a gas mask.
Yeah, why not? Yeah.
And another girl's wearing like a bandana over her face, and there's this one guy who's got he's wearing all white, except the shirt looks like something out of Andrew WK. It looks like it's covered in blood. The
Yeah.
pants
Okay.
are stark white,
Yeah.
but they're covered, and they're like covered in fringe.
Are you
Because
sure it
fringe.
wasn't just Andrew WK?
I'm pretty sure, because this guy had short hair.
Oh,
This Andrew WK wouldn't cut his
yeah, you
hair
can't
for
have
the life
short
of him.
hair. You're doing it wrong. You gotta
And
be
they
able to
just.
do, like, metal shit while you're playing piano in a joyous fashion. That's how Andrew WK works.
It was an experience. I'll have to share the video with you later. I'll just say, like,
Jesus.
how do people. Sometimes I look at, like, the hardcore punks like that, right? And I'm like, I thought we were done with this. Like, you figure
No,
that's
they're
something that,
far from
like.
done.
You
Especially
figure.
in like London, there's like huge punk and goth scenes and stuff. They're still around.
You just kind of figure that, like, that was a phase in high school that went away.
Nah, that's still a
It
thing.
doesn't. It doesn't.
Oh shit, wow, cool. Okay. I know this is random. I just opened a chest and I got a ship blueprint and a legendary engram. That's
Oh.
probably the best thing I've ever gotten out of a patrol chest ever. Usually it's just like one spin metal and you're like, "Thanks, patrol chest." This time it was like something nice.
You're
So
like,
you're like,
oh,
"Oh,
thanks, man.
cool." I'm pleasantly surprised.
What's new with you, Alan? What are you gonna do for your birthday? Tell me about it.
Nothing. I'm just gonna go out to at I have reservations at 7 at an Italian restaurant.
Oh yeah. Is
Mambo
that
Italiano. I don't know why I sound like
we're
a.
going to? Yeah, jeez, that was racist. What,
Hey, oh! You get
we're
your
going.
grinder on my grinder.
We're doing the grinder. Sorry, Rob Lowe.
You know what, man? When Nicole was going to Chapman, there was this sandwich place by, and I used to like beg to go there because it was called the Grinder, and they made their own bread. It was like fresh bread. It was the
Ooh.
best. It was so fucking good. Like some of the best sandwiches ever. But yeah, every time I hear the Grinder, I'm like, fuck, I miss that place so much. There was also a place that made waffle sandwiches, which sounds really odd. But they were like the best thing ever. And actually they didn't really put sugar in the waffle, so it was like I don't know. So when you got like a waffle burger, it wasn't like sweet on the outside, right? It was just
Right.
like the waffle kind of texture and the look, but no sugar, so it was like just eating a regular burger. But like oh, it was super good. Everybody I told like you gotta get the waffle burger. If they're like, what?
They're
Like,
like,
oh no, you don't
what are you
even
talking
know. You
about?
don't even know. It's so good. Yeah, the
Well,
grinder.
the grindia.
Getting you grindier, I'm a grindier. I am, yeah, birthdays.
Yeah, we're going
Yeah, I'm
to.
22.
Wait, what'd you
We're
say?
going. He's 22.
Said, yeah, I'm 22.
I don't,
Damn.
he doesn't know about you, but he's feeling 22.
Dude, okay, when I hear that song, before I knew the name of the song, I didn't know what she was saying there, and it always sounded like she was saying, "I don't know about you, but I'm feeling sweaty too." And I knew that wasn't right, but
But it
it
makes it
sounds
so much
like it.
better.
And now when I tell people that, they're like, "I can't fucking unhear it. It's sweaty too." And I'm like, "Yeah. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling sweaty too." I love it so much. Such a great like way to think about that song. But then it reminds me of like, hey, I'm sweating. Are you sweating?
And yeah, I'm sweating.
How do we stop sweating?
I was watching a children's program just before we got on here.
Like parents often do.
Because I have a 2-year-old. And I found that it's more bearable when I make fun of it.
It depends on what kind of children's show it is, though. Some of them are kind
of... It's always
like, well,
Daniel
oh, no,
Tiger!
She's a 2-year-old. None of them are enjoyable.
Alright. Daniel Tiger is basically like... It's kind of like a spin-off or some sort or a spiritual successor of Mr. Rogers.
Oh, yeah?
So, Mr. Rogers is cool. So, for a while, Daniel Tiger was pretty cool.
Hello there, neighbor.
It was pretty cool for a while. And then, I watch all 50 episodes a dozen times, and now it's not cool anymore.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. As 2-year-olds do, they watch the same shit over and over again. That's when you just start introducing them to new shit, like, every 5 minutes.
So now I either take it dark, or I just, like, I take it to a realistic place where I, Daniel Tiger, being a tiger, makes a lot of puns. He's always like,
tigers?
He's like, it's terrific! Or he says, it's tiger-tastic! And I just want one of his friends to be like, you know, it's not always about you, Daniel.
It's not a that's not a pun, that's a hate crime. Right? That was fucking terrible what you just told me. Tiger-rific, go fuck yourself.
Tiger-tastic, alright.
Oh god, that's,
And there's another thing, like, the kids in this show are probably
annoying.
Oh yeah, but Max 5 years old, right? And I realized the difference between 5-year-olds and 25-year-olds. One of the major differences, other than, of course, the age.
20 years.
Well, yeah. But, there's an episode where they have, like, this talent show at the school. And he gets up there to sing. And his song literally is, "My name is Daniel Tiger, and I like my friends just the way they are. I'm Daniel," and that's the song.
That's awful.
And all his friends are like, "Yeah, that fucking rule." Well, not, I mean, not really, but they're like,
"Yeah,
that'd be
amazing."
Great
fucking song, Daniel.
Yeah, Daniel, that was awesome. And like
that was fucking Armadillo Rillick. I'm imagining one of his friends is like an armadillo.
No armadillos. But
that's armadillo-tastic.
But yeah, so I'm looking at it and I'm like, so there's a 5-year-old's reaction to that, which is like, rad, that was a cool song, Daniel. And then there's a 25-year-old's reaction, which is like, you suck, get off the stage, that didn't even rhyme.
Shut the fuck up, Daniel.
Like,
I'll fucking kill you, Daniel. I'll come to your house and murder you.
I told my fiance one day.
Oh my god, dude.
I told my fiance that one day she's gonna come to me like with a drawing or something. And I'm not gonna lie to her. She's gonna be like, "I drew this for you. It's an elephant, and it's like a bunch of scribbles." And she's gonna be like, "Oh my god, it's so beautiful. We're gonna put it on the fridge." And she's gonna be like, "What do you think, Daddy?" And I'll be like, "Well, I mean, the important thing is that you tried."
Jesus, it's not what you say.
It's not what you're supposed to say.
No.
Are you sure?
Not at all. Not at all.
Not at all. But sometimes I take it, I take it dark, right? I'll be like, there's a, actually the same episode, no, not the same episodes. It was a different episode about like sames and differences, you know, like Daniel's too fucking.
Sames and differences.
Yes, thank you. I'll give it a hug, yes.
Just say hug it. Rub it on
Hug
yourself. I'm...
Zipped on my headphone. Yeah. Party chat. So.
I'll kill you, Dad.
I'll kill you, old man. One day I'm gonna take your place, old man. And then
One
my
day I'll
vengeance.
stand on
And
top of
then
a
my
mountain of
vengeance
skulls.
will be complete.
Oh, man.
Sometimes, yeah, the things and differences. Daniel is apparently too stupid. Because he's like. He's hanging out with two of the human characters. And they mention the tail, and he's like, oh, but you don't have tails. I'm different. Oh, man. And he completely forgets that there's a fucking cat and an owl in his class. Like,
Two of which have tails.
until like 20 minutes later. I mean, it's like,
He's
oh
like,
yeah.
oh yeah!
He's like,
I'm actually the
oh yeah.
majority!
He's like, oh yeah. We have tails. And the teacher's going around,
You're
right?
the minority! And then all of a sudden it becomes this dark, twisted
Like
1984 tale.
Logan's Run or something like that. Anyone who doesn't have a tail is executed.
All non-tails must die!
So the teacher's going around taking pictures of the sames and differences. At one point, you know, like one of the girls is an African girl, and one of the other girls is a white girl. So they're like, my skin is pinkish, my skin is brownish, and they take pictures and whatnot, which is a strange thing to take pictures of, honestly. But
Yeah.
when he finally finds the other people in the class that have been there the whole time, I remind you, that have tails, they're like, let's take pictures of our tails. And the teacher comes over, and
She's like, nope, you're not doing that.
she like brings the camera over, and three children stick their asses out to show her their tails. And I'm like, Teacher Harriet's about to end up on a watch list, okay?
That
Oh
reminds me
my
of that scene
God.
from Kindergarten Cop.
Like, that's tough.
Was there a pedophile in Kindergarten Cop? I feel like there was.
No. There's a scene where a kid
I
is
feel like that
has a
movie
doll
was
with him.
ripe for pedophiles.
Kid has a doll, and he's looking. There are girls standing on top of the desks, and he's looking up. Pants or their skirts.
Oh, that's right. I remember that.
And he's checking the
It's
doll the
just,
way it looks.
you know,
It was just,
skipping.
I don't know how they got away with it.
It was a different time.
It was
But yeah, it was a pre-9/11 world.
Damn. I mean, he's not wrong.
So that's
I don't
technically
know if that
true.
was the exact reasoning, but he's not exactly wrong.
There was. There. Oh.
Arnold's like, 9/11 hasn't happened yet. We can get away with it.
After every
Oh my
episode.
God.
After every episode, that or like little cartoon, you know, because it's like it's kind of built like Rugrats and Doug and shit was, you know, where it was you know, two little shorts separated by a commercial break. So after each short, they visit real neighbors. They visit real life children, doing something pertaining to the lesson. And I don't remember the lesson, honestly, but the point is
A
that they're,
great
it's
way to
all.
take in the tiger's lessons.
I don't care. But. And the point is that there's a woman at a park who's painting faces. And as we've already established, the three animals are are a tiger, a cat, and an owl. And so the first kid comes around, and they paint his face as a tiger. And the second kid comes around, they paint her face as a cat. And of course, the third one is an owl. But the first thing I think of
so
is...
So they're all an animal face now.
But the first thing that I think of is, how fucked up would it be if they, like, paint her as a little African girl in blackface?
Oh, God.
Like, she looks like my friend. And they don't even act like it's wrong. They're just like, she looks like my friend, Miss Elena.
Oh, God.
I always try to imagine, like, the parent, like the parents.
I see how watching this show could be fun. If...
The parents' reaction to like if this actually happened, like if a parent is watching this,
all the kids are just like, "Yeah, she does," and then it...
like I just nothing makes me happier than like thinking of a situation where a parent would be watching this with their children and be like, "The fuck's going on? Is this really? Am I seeing this?" Like.
Is this for real?
Like, that makes me so happy.
Where are you, Ashton? Am I being punked?
I'm being punked?
Am I being scooped or puked or some shit?
Dunked? Okay, let me tell you something. I don't like Tosh.0. But I was on a plane, and... It was either that or Big Bang Theory, and we all know how I feel about Big Bang Theory. It's not fucking funny.
Have you ever seen that clip of the guy
yes.
watching the clip from Big Bang Theory, and then he just screams?
Yes.
That was like the funniest fucking thing. Oh my God. He just made a bunch of references!
So I just...
Why are you laughing?
So I chose the lesser of two evils. And I didn't really laugh very much. But I lost it. I don't know if you've ever seen this. I lost it when they made Junked. Junked is they talk about a young man who played a prank on his mom. I don't remember what again my memory's for shit. I don't exactly remember what the prank was. I think he said that he was gonna be arrested or something like that.
Mom, I'm getting arrested! And he's just looking at the phone and I get some sly-ass face.
The thing that Tosh focuses on in this video is that the kid cannot stop scratching his nuts while he's doing this. So, he says, we're gonna make a new reality show. I'm gonna have you as a waiter. I want you to, like, go to different people and serve their order. But don't stop scratching your nuts. Like, so he goes there, and it's not even like the scenario where he goes up there and he scratches his nuts and he's making them uncomfortable. That's not the funny part. The funny part is when Tosh runs out there, he's like, "You stupid asshole, you're on Junk," and then he has to tell the kid, he's like, "Stop touching your dick," every time. And then he's like, this guy's over here, he's not even real. He, like, throws water in his face. And then in the next one, he's like, "Oh, you stupid punk motherfucker, you're on Junk, stop touching your dick. Look at this guy, he's got water in his face." Isn't that stupid? He throws water in his face again. Like, and the best part is the guy's, like, reaction when he gets the water thrown in his face. He just keeps laughing, like, "Haha, it's part of the joke." Like, I'm not real. I have water on my face. Didn't you think that was weird?
Isn't that funny? Oh my God, Mom. I'm on TV. You know Tosh is an admitted, like, joke thief, right?
Is he?
Yeah.
I'm not surprised.
I heard that on Joe Rogan.
Well, dang. That's too bad, because I... thought he was funny, like, in his stand-up.
Yeah, so. Some of his stand-up was pretty funny. You know what kind of, what's weird is, he's like, someone I like, but I think Aziz Ansari, like, his very first stand-up special is great.
Uh-huh.
And then his second one is not good. And I don't know what happened. I'm like, is that all he had in him? You know?
I don't think I watched it.
Is that it? we can't even finish it, but I think he's a way better actor than a stand-up, honestly.
Yeah.
Like, he's great in Parks and Rec. Master of None was really good.
I loved Master of None.
Which, that's getting a second season, so that's cool.
I thought it ended perfectly, too.
Yeah, it ended really well.
Who, did you Nicole's see?
Like, I'm upset he's not going to Japan. I'm like, fuck that, why? I'm like, I wouldn't.
Why would he? He knows better.
Yeah, I'm like, I wouldn't go. Spoilers.
Spoilers.
Not really, it's vague enough.
I was gonna say something about it, and you got me sidetracked on Master. Oh, no, you know what? I remember now. Did you, how Nicole went to see, Deadpool last
she
night?
She saw Deadpool, yeah.
Did she like it?
She said she liked it. She said it's funny.
Well, there you go. See, now Allan can go see it.
Good.
Now Allan can go see it. Go see it, Allan. You like
it. I don't want to support Rob Liefeld.
Well, I mean, you know.
I mean, it's apparently good. I have, like, really no interest
okay,
in seeing it, period,
it,
but I'm gonna see it at some point. Just
yeah,
because
motherfucker,
it's...
like, if you like Deadpool at all, you're supporting Rob Liefeld, okay?
Yeah.
So.
I mean, I don't really give a shit about Deadpool. I don't give a shit about the movie, but I'll probably end up seeing it just because everybody says it's good and it's funny, so we'll see, you know.
I'm more likely to see the second one because Cable's gonna be in it.
Or, you could see the first one.
Yeah, I don't... Yeah, you're the guy who bought fucking...
Aliens Colonial Marines three times.
Aliens Colonial Marines, you knew exactly where I was going. Like, three times. She won't go see Deadpool, which is like a... It's like a 90-something on Rotten Tomatoes, I think.
Yeah. This is a guy that's complained about Man of Steel for like 3 years, and never actually saw it until today.
Yeah, that movie's not that bad. It's not that bad. I mean, it's not great,
well,
but it's not, like,
it
horrible.
It's not a great movie. It's not
I wish it had been more like Captain America
right.
1, which is, I think, what we talked about yesterday.
I ran across,
yeah,
okay.
I wish it had been more like... I mean, Captain America 1 is very... It's kind of lighthearted, in a way, because
right.
it's, like, an older, like, good old days superhero story.
Speaking of Captain America, I ran across... I don't know if you guys use Time Hop. At all.
No.
It's interesting to...
Facebook.
Well, you don't have to use Facebook. Time Hop has its own app.
I think I tried to, and it didn't work with my Twitter, and I said, fuck it, I don't care.
I love using Time Hop because it brings back a lot of old quotes that I forget about. Because I post a lot of shit on Twitter. Quotes that make me laugh. A lot of times out of context, which makes it better. But, I had to search for this one.
And then
one.
Years later, we're like, I don't know what the fuck I was saying.
But it's still funny. But I had to search for this one. I didn't know what I was talking about. But apparently there's an article on College Humor that I complained about last year called... shoot, I know the name of this one. It's Movies That Turn to Shit. After like the first 20 minutes. And Captain America the First Avenger was on there.
I disagree. I really like that movie.
That movie's great. He complains that it basically becomes a big ad for Avengers, which I was like, well, duh. But
it's in the title.
It's still a good movie in its own right. That doesn't... And the tweet in question was like, because I'm never afraid to call anyone out, was like Captain America is a shitty movie, Dan Hopper's a fool, and he never replied. I wish he could, so he could be like listen here, fucko.
Yeah, because you trolled him. Why would he?
I wish
he'd probably like, look at this douchebag.
Well, look at that douchebag. He thinks Captain America's a bad movie. He's wrong.
But he has a right to think it. You could disagree.
Everybody.
But
has
he
a
has
right
a
to,
right to his
Everybody
opinion.
Has a right to be wrong.
Nicole didn't think Ex Machina was all that great, and I told her she was wrong, but I still live with her.
That was pretty good. I enjoyed
my
time.
That was my favorite movie last year.
I know,
it was fantastic.
That means something. You don't like anything.
No, I love a lot of things. I'm just very critical of things.
I know.
And when something does, like when people do film right, that's when I really like it. Like for example, Mad Max. Movie's great because
still
it's
haven't
like
seen Mad Max.
It does so
to.
Many. It does so many great things.
When we when we hang out next time, we gotta watch Mad Max.
I own it. I'll bring it. So. What's great about it is like, I mean, it's like an A-tier fucking director. Like George Miller,
right.
Has been around. You know, he knows what the fuck he's doing. The cinematography is like great. It has some amazing shots in it. The storytelling doesn't treat you like an idiot. There's little to no exposition ever in the entire movie. It just kind of plays out. And I think that's where a lot of people who don't like it get hung up. Like they're like, I don't get it. Because nothing is ever explained. It's meant to you're supposed to just kind of fill it in, like with your own imagination, which I really like, because then it's like, you kind of interpret it the way you want to interpret it. I think that's awesome. Like, nobody fucking does that. Like, nobody has the balls to do that. And I guess it works because, you know, it got nominated for Golden Globes and for fucking Oscars. So, you know. But, yeah, like, that's an example of a movie that, like, this does filmmaking correctly. Like, Ex Machina doesn't, like, things I like about it. It's got a lot of, like, deep subject matter in it, which I'm always into. I love, like, underlying subject matter. It's got really great cinematography, really good special effects. It's a relatively short movie because it doesn't need to... It knows it doesn't need to be that long. It's almost like a short story.
Yeah, it doesn't need to overstay its welcome.
Yeah, and it doesn't waste, like, 20 minutes in the beginning explaining, like, who the main character is, what this whole contest thing is. Like, giving you backstory, it literally just throws you in, and I absolutely loved that. I was like, cool, don't waste any time. I'll learn who this character is over the course of the film. I don't need you to tell me, like, outright, you know? And, like, that's an example of, again, a movie that does stuff right. And then at the end, it leaves you with a bunch of questions, which I love it when... I love movies that have a little bit of ambiguity.
Oh, yeah.
Star Wars is just Star Wars, but on top of that, it has great cinematography. I thought the writing was fun and clever. Obviously, like, Starkiller Base probably didn't need to be in it, period, but pushing that aside, like, and the special effects works great, the music's great. Like, there's really good shots in the movie that are really impressive. The lighting is, like, used for storytelling, which I love when that kind of shit happens. So that's another example of a movie that's like, yes, you're doing it right, you know. Like, I get mad when I watch a movie and there's like tons of plot holes. Like, that annoys me when I'm like, why didn't you just do this, you know, or something. I don't know. It's one of those things. Like, I'm trying to think of a movie I really didn't like last year, but I don't think I watched that many.
I don't know what came out last year. Well,
A shitload.
I liked
Ant-Man.
I liked Ant-Man.
Which is funny because a lot of the people half the people I saw it with didn't like it. And I'm like,
that's,
I don't know what
insane.
You thought this was.
Yeah, like, well,
it's
like
called
what?
Ant-Man.
I just rewatched that actually 2 days ago, I think. Either yesterday or the day before. I think it was the day before.
Yeah, my dad, it's so funny, every movie that my dad goes, that movie looks like it's gonna be really shitty, he ends up loving. Like, when the first trailer for the first Thor came out, I was super excited, because Thor is my favorite Marvel character.
Oh, Thor's awesome.
And, yeah, because I'm really into
mythology.
Thor, the literal Thor is literally in this, that's
I
amazing.
Actually had no idea what to expect out of Thor, because I didn't really know him, like, as well as...
Did you didn't read
Iron
any
Man.
Of the, like, Straczynski Thor
no.
or anything?
Well, no, oh, okay. I think...
That's some good Thor.
Allan,
that is some good-ass Thor.
I think our friend Allan, he let me borrow Volume 1. And I actually have all three volumes now, but I still haven't read them. I will eventually.
Isn't the third one not Straczynski, though? Somebody else?
I know, I think it is. I have it right here. Let me see.
If only someone would make a Straczynski Spider-Man movie. Jesus Christ.
Spider-Man.
It'd be
no,
over.
The third
That's
one's
like the best. the best Spider-Man that I've ever read.
What,
it's
one more
so
day?
good.
One more day.
Yeah,
one
and
moment in
and
time.
That whole
Spider-Man no
collection
more.
that he did has like the 9/11 issue in it, which is like one of the best single issue comics I've ever read. It's like so heart-wrenching.
Covers too.
While we're on the topic with Marvel, I want to say something that's been bugging me. I really want to sit down with Kevin Feige, because he's the producer. He's basically the head of Marvel. Well, I don't know if he's the head of Marvel Studios,
so like
but
the MCU, the
he's the one that he's the face of the of you know Marvel Studios.
Okay, so he's like whatever her name is, who's running Star Wars over at Disney right now.
Sure.
Kathleen
Kennedy. Yeah, I know it had like a K. Yeah, Kathleen Kennedy's like the brains behind the operation, like making
he's
sure
president.
Everything's like fine. Basically.
But I want to understand the reasoning behind the structure of the faces. Okay.
The way I always thought about it was like, did you read all the Green Lantern up to Blackest Night, right? Didn't you? Weren't you one of those people?
I read
like
I read
Sinestro Core War, Rise of the Red Lanterns.
No,
and all
I've never
that
read
stuff.
That. I never read that.
Oh, well, the way I always thought about it was like the phases in like all of them was like it was 10 years worth of comics all leading up to Blackest Night, which was, you know, that big event with the fucking
right. I read Blackest Night.
Yeah, so there's a whole bunch of there's a shitload of comics you had to read to like really get all the context. So like there's some intro Green Lantern stuff where it's like, Hal Jordan's back, he's fucking Green Lantern, it's not Kyle Rayner, all that shit.
Green Lantern.
And then, yeah, so it's like a origin story, and then they get into the Green Lantern core, and then they introduce people like Kyle Rayner and all that stuff. And then it goes to Sinestro Corps War, which was like when Sinestro starts the Sinestro Corps. And then there's a whole series for that, which is like fucking awesome. If you've never read, people out there, if you've never read Sinestro Corps War, it's so good. Like, you actually don't even need to know that much about Green Lantern. You just need to know that, like, Green Lanterns protect the galaxy. Sinestro was one, and now he's a bad guy. and then you can jump in, and it's like fucking Star Wars. It's great. And then after that, it's like
Green Lantern Rebirth, they brought back Sinestro and
that was like a retreading of the origin, like they do, like where they update it. Where like Superman, when they did Secret Origin, like that was like, this is now the canon Superman origin story. Like it's been updated, basically. Which now it doesn't matter because there's a new 52, and then there's that whole like they're teasing that whole rebirth thing right now. I'm like, I can't even keep up with the shit anymore. But the way I've seen Marvel phases is like similar to that. It's like phase two for the Green Lantern comics leading into, because we're leading into the Infinity Gauntlet, right?
Yeah.
So it's like the Infinity Gauntlet
here's
to me is like Blackest Night. So it's like we're just like phase two would have been like Sinestro Corps Wars. Phase three would have been like Rise of the Red Lanterns, and then.
Well, see, here's my problem with it. It's just the endings. Okay?
Oh, so you want like a coherent arc over all the movies.
Okay, if we're looking at I'm fine with the structure for the most part. It's just that if we're looking at each phase as a book and each movie as a chapter in that book, then phase one happens and phase one ends on Avengers. It's a great way to end phase one, to end the book, so to speak. And it's because it's what you've been working for, working towards. 2008 rolls along, Iron Man comes out, and we're like, oh, it's cool, Iron Man movie, right on. And then comes, and then at the very end, after the credits, I'm here to talk to you about the Avengers Initiative. And you're like, holy shit, what? Right?
Yeah.
So now you know what you're working towards. You finally get to the Avengers, and you're like, we did it. You guys did it. You have Captain America, you have Thor, you have Black Widow, and Hawkeye, and Nick Fury, and Iron Man. They're all on the same screen, and there's Hulk, too. Oh, my God, this is amazing.
And it works.
And it works.
Yeah.
And then, mid-credit scene, Thanos. And you're like, oh, my God, I get it now. This is what you're working towards. When it's all said and done, because this can't last forever, but...
No. Well, they said it will.
they'll try, but at the very least, they want to make it to Infinity War. Thanos is one of their biggest adversaries. Oh.
She is going off about Thanos. She's like, let me tell you about Thanos.
Thanos is one of their biggest adversaries. Infinity War.
He's like the dark seed or side, however you say it.
Dark side.
Marvel, basically. See, I always said that, and then I've had people be like, no, it's dark seed.
Well, they're wrong.
I'm like, no, it isn't, you fuck. And then I get corrected.
Infinity War, Infinity Gauntlet, Infinity Stones. It's all happening. You know? And that's what they want to work towards. Yeah? Is that right? Trying to complain about the structure of the Marvel Universe, all right?
Complain about the structure.
But then Phase 2 rolls around, and, you know, you're shaking things up. Winter Soldier shakes things up. You're like, oh, shit.
Damn, and
you got Hydra coming around. Spoilers.
Still around somehow.
Still around. They say that the last stronghold was in Age of Ultron, and then there's a little bit of Hydra going around in Ant-Man, just a little bit. But
yeah,
okay. So now we're in Book 2, Phase 2.
But does Ant-Man? No, it doesn't. I was gonna say, does Ant-Man take place before? Because I know that the movies will come out in different orders, but they're not necessarily
at this point. Phase one was a tougher one because everything was kind of happening at the same time, and you notice that, like Iron Man 2, Stark is watching the scene in Incredible Hulk, and Coulson obviously
happens after Iron Man because they reference Stark, yeah. Like, oh, is this one of Stark's fucking things? And then they're like, I don't know. And then it blasts them.
Yeah. So, I'm not... but now, after Phase 2, it all comes out in real time, except for Iron Man 3, obviously, because it was set in Christmas and came out in May. But... And that was still my least favorite movie, I gotta be honest with you.
I still haven't seen it. I think that's the only Marvel movie that I haven't seen, if I remember correctly.
Like, every movie is good in its own right, but I was pretty disappointed with that one.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I never saw that one. Thor 2 was disappointing to me.
I liked Thor 2.
It was whatever.
It was not my favorite, but...
It wasn't horrible,
I still think the first Thor is the best.
It is great.
Very Shakespearean.
But that's one of those movies that my dad was like, this movie looks like shit. And then I'm like, Dad, it's fucking... it's Thor, son of Odin, fighting ice trolls. Like, what do you expect? Like, just go with it. And then he watched it and liked it. God damn it, Dad.
Now, I'm looking at my shelf full of Marvel movies. You got Phase 2, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is introduced. That's a little nice, you know.
Yeah, I don't watch that though. I don't really care.
Hold on. It took a while to build.
Jessica Jones, and I'm in the middle of Clone Wars. I can't, you know, I can't back
down
now. You
gotta finish Jessica Jones.
Right?
You gotta finish.
I know,
Jessica
but
Jones.
I gotta finish Good. Clone Wars first.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Daredevil season 2 is about
Alan
to come
will
out.
Back me up. Clone Wars is the shit. You've seen it, right?
Oh man, I love Clone Wars.
Oh, it's so good. I'm like in season 4 right now, and it's like so fucking good. Now they're starting to allude to like all the episode 3 shit, and I'm like, oh, this is fucking great.
But
it's
okay,
a great show.
Second book chapters. and Avengers comes along, and you're like, okay, no fan, like we've in this book we've learned more about the Infinity Stones. We have the Tesseract, we have the Aether, we have what was it? The orb from Guardians of the Galaxy. Thanos makes an appearance. And they and the Collector is talking about the Infinity Stones, and then we get a fourth Infinity Stone in the Mind Stone from Loki's scepter in Avengers. No Thanos in the Avengers. You're not fighting Thanos, but at the very end, he puts on the gauntlet and he's like, "Fine, I'll do it myself." And you're like, "Oh shit, it's coming! He's coming. It's next!" Yes, I see it.
She's trying to tell you about Thanos. She's trying to tell you why you're wrong. But she doesn't have the language skills yet.
And you're like, it's coming, it's coming. And that's a perfect way to end the phase. But instead, they're like, no, one more chapter. And they end it on Ant-Man. Right?
Do they really?
Yes. Ant-Man was originally going to be the start of Phase 3, but then they moved it. They were like, actually, we're going to say it's the end of Phase 2. And I was like, but why? Like, that seems like
a little random.
That seems a little strange to, like, to end it on, right? Like, right. I don't mind that it's there. It's just, if we're looking at it in my analogy where each phase is a book and each movie is a chapter in that book, it seems like a strange way to end the book. And again, yeah. And again,
but it also feels like it couldn't, like, it doesn't really, but yeah, it could work as the beginning of three, because, like, there's nothing happening yet, and that's, like, a good, like, and none of it really, like,
I feel like they wanted Civil Wars.
Really matters. Like, Ant-Man doesn't have any, like, large impact on the world as a whole.
Minus, you know, fighting Falcon and Falcon being like, I know a guy.
Yeah. Well, yeah, but I mean, yeah, there's, like, little cameos, like, there would be in a comic book, but I'm saying, like, the events of Ant-Man don't really have, like, a significant impact on the world of the MCU, except in the fact that they introduce, like, Ant-Man and Wasp. That's, like, really right. It.
Well, you are forgetting the second credit scene.
Yeah, after the credits.
What was that again?
That was when it was Falcon and Cap found Bucky.
Bucky.
Oh. Well, that was
and
more of a
even
tease for, like,
the Accords of Civil War.
Yeah, but that was a tease for the next movie. That wasn't really like a Thanos thing. You know what I mean?
Right.
So
it just seems seems strange that they didn't end on Avengers. And then
I get that.
And then here we go with Phase 3, which is bigger than all the other phases. You know, it's gonna be 11 movies. We got and six
players doing that to bring in.
Six of them are sequels. Two Avengers movies, one Thor movie, one Captain America movie.
Doing the Infinity War thing in two parts, right?
A Guardians movie and Ant-Man and the Wasp.
Yeah.
And then the other five are Captain Marvel, Spider-Man, Black Panther, Doctor Strange, and Inhumans.
Well, Inhumans might not happen.
Yeah, I keep hearing that it might not happen.
Who's saying that?
Mainly because of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Yeah, because I heard they might do that.
I know that they introduced the idea of Inhumans in S.H.I.E.L.D.
Right, but
I thought they were kind of leading to this movie.
I had been hearing there had been trouble with it or something, and that I don't.
Well, and that would nullify.
It doesn't matter to me. If it comes out, I'll go see it.
And that kind of nullifies the my complaint, which is that you're working towards Infinity War, and supposedly, if it happens, Inhumans is supposed to end Phase 3. Like, it goes Avengers Infinity War Part 2 and then Inhumans.
But it's like I said, that doesn't necessarily, like, because the movies come out in a specific order doesn't necessarily mean that the timeline is in that order.
But at this point, we do know that they're basically coming out in real time, because they're now mixing with Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Like Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. did references to Avengers before and after in the episodes that came that aired before the release and after the release. Before the like, you don't watch it, so I'll explain it. So in the episode before Avengers came out, they go to Sokovia under the pretense of looking for something else, but Phil finds a base and he calls Maria Hill and he says I found where Strucker's located, call him the Avengers. And then they keep talking about this thing called Theta Protocol throughout the last few episodes. And then we find out in the episode after the Avengers was released that Theta Protocol was the life-saving helicarrier that Nick Fury brought up to save the citizens of the floating city of Sokovia. So
I did not like Ultron.
I think that it was an okay movie.
That the first like 30 minutes were very enjoyable.
Very muddled.
But then after that it turned into this weird fucking movie. I don't know. But like I said, the first 30 minutes were very enjoyable. Like them fighting in the base, I'm like, cool. And then after that, like the party in the tower, I'm like, this is all really funny. And then after that it got like
especially
it started
Stanley's
to go downhill.
Part.
Huh?
Stanley's
especially
part.
Stanley's part.
Which he
what
said
he
is
doing again?
He had the Asgardian ale.
He's like, I can take it. And he just has to be taken out by
and he says Excelsior.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay. That's supposedly is his favorite cameo that he's done.
Was it you I was talking to when Stan Lee was like, I would love it if like the MCU and the Star Wars movies mixed, and I was like, no, thank you.
I think we were talking about that.
Yeah.
I was like, no thank you. That's not necessary.
Leave that shit to Disney Infinity.
Let's not go there.
Yeah. Let's not do that. Like. Ever, just let them be. Like when Marvel owned Transformers, and they were publishing the Transformers comics before IDW had it. Apparently, and I had read this on the wiki, the Transformers were considered part of the Marvel universe for a little while. And I thought that was really weird. I don't think that's not the case anymore, obviously, but like. Because there are comics where it's like Megatron and fucking Spider-Man are on the same cover.
Right.
And you're like, this is fucking weird, you know?
But, that was my beef. That's if Inhumans doesn't happen, then I guess I don't have anything to complain about. But I'm still a little confused as to why Phase 2 ended on Ant-Man, and if it does come out, why Phase 3 would end on Inhumans. Especially when you've been working so hard to establish that Thanos is what you're building towards.
I don't have an answer for you.
Kevin Feige, tweet at me. We'll talk.
Would have an answer. Yeah, he's going to talk to you.
out of anybody, he's going to talk to me. He's like, there's this one guy on a streaming podcast that nobody really knows about that has some questions, and I'm here to answer them.
I'm here to answer them within the bounds of my employer contract.
Right.
You probably can't talk about much. Like,
probably not at all.
Most people in those positions can't say much until they get, like, you know, they have all this shit planned out.
They can't.
For years, and then they're like, we're not going to announce this particular thing until, like.
They can't even show Spider-Man in Civil War stuff. Because they're like, I don't know if we can. Like, I don't know if Sony will let us.
Oh, yeah.
Because of the rights. They're still sharing rights.
Yeah. Well, it'll be more surprising. I know that people like us know it's going to happen, but how many people out there have no fucking idea? You know what I mean?
There's a fucking rumor that, Steve Buscemi will be Uncle Ben.
I am in love with that.
I was like, let's be real though. Steve Buscemi would never land Marissa Tomei. So
he's just like, hey, Peter. Oh, that's my best fucking Steve Buscemi impression.
He just sounds like Lois.
Yeah, Peter. I was in Boardwalk Empire. Listen to me. I'm your moral compass.
But I'm not going to tell you to let a bus full of children drown.
Oh my
god.
Well,
Uncle Ben may be coming back.
From the dead!
I thought that was one of the characters that you don't bring back, like him and Gwen Stacy.
Well, Gwen is already back in a parallel universe.
Well, that's a parallel. Spider-Gwen is her own universe.
Yeah.
Which, if they made a movie of that, that would be fucking cool.
Goddamn comics.
I'd be totally dead. And they got, you know, I don't know. They got some actress. Obviously, they have to get an actress, but like...
Sure.
Because Marvel's doing this...
I thought I was going to have a name, and then nothing came out. And I went, nope, never mind.
Nope, I don't have anything.
I don't have anything.
It is pretty astounding.
This Marvel movie would be really cool, too.
Well, that's happening. Well, Captain Marvel.
Captain Marvel's happening, but that's not the same.
It's not the same.
No. Captain Marvel is.
Wait, Miss Marvel
like a tall
is
blonde.
Is
like a tall blonde woman who fought in like
Carol
World
Danvers.
War II and shit.
Yeah.
Miss Marvel's like that Muslim girl stretch and. Like,
is that DC?
Stuff. No, that's Marvel.
Are you sure?
Yeah, Miss Marvel is Marvel. And Captain Marvel, not Shazam. Captain Marvel is a tall blonde woman. Who Ronda Rousey like wanted to play. You don't remember that?
I do remember that.
Miss Marvel is like there was a big deal because Miss Marvel used to be a wasn't it like a white girl and they changed her into a Muslim girl.
I feel like I have a children's
Not
book.
Not just that, she's an Inhuman too.
She's what?
An Inhuman.
What's the girl's name in the Marvel family for DC?
Mary?
Was it Marvel Girl?
Mary Marvel.
I have a book. You know what? I have a book here.
Mary Marvel is Shazam's sister.
I have
it's
a
Billy's
book.
Sister.
Hold on.
Yeah.
You son of a bitch. I have a book here somewhere.
It is
Damn
Mary.
It.
I'm telling you, Shazam is my favorite DC character. I'm telling you right now, it's Mary.
You're probably right. I just want to look for it. There's a book here. For a children's book that we
and
bought.
I also
there
know the Miss Marvel shit because Nicole's been reading it. She's got obsessed with it.
My
she
first book of girl power. There's a page with, I think, Mary Marvel on here.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Mary is a regular girl who has superpowers some of the time. She says Shazam when she needs super
like
strength
really.
Or wisdom. Here you go. You're welcome.
She's pissed. She's like, God
She's
damn
like,
it.
She's like, hey, a book. Can you give it to me? I'm like, sure.
Touching my shit.
Okay. It is pretty astounding what they've done with this Marvel Universe. You need to finish that Jessica Jones, because it's so goddamn good. I'm actually rewatching it. And I just finished it. So. Do
what?
That.
Wait, say that again? I'm sorry.
I said you need to watch Jessica Jones, because...
Oh, I know. I've only watched the first two episodes, and I really like it.
I just got caught up
in Clone Wars, and then didn't. I haven't been watching like anything else.
I just finished it recently, and I'm rewatching it.
Yeah, I don't do that though.
Well,
I don't rewatch shows unless they're like comedy shows that I can play in the background. Like
yeah,
we've
you...
been rewatching 30 Rock when we are just not watching stuff, and
you guys
God damn,
always
that show's so good.
But you guys always go for The Office as well.
We go through phases, like we rewatch stuff and then we're like, oh, we haven't rewatched this in a long time, so we just put that in the background. And it's been 30 Rock lately.
Lee
recently just restarted Parks and Rec.
So good. I think I've watched Parks and Rec like 5 times all the way through.
So good.
It is. It's one of the best shows.
Except for the first like on the first season and a half, or the first 2 seasons are kind of dull, but only because like they're good, but
it's trying to be The Office.
They're good, but Leslie's a little dumber.
Trying to be The Office.
And Mark Brandanowicz is in play, and that's
fucking Mark Brandanowicz.
Mark Brandana quits.
Because he quits at that one episode.
Yeah, as soon as Chris and Ben show up, like that's the best.
Yeah, well, that's when the show gets really good. But like even before that, it's still pretty good. But
it's still good. It's just, man, Mark is just.
But it is
so,
trying to be
so
the
boring.
Office.
Mark is really boring. He's
Mark
a boring character.
Is boring as fuck. But yeah, like right. You can tell,
like
it's, the DNA in it is like the first season is basically like the first 2 seasons of The Office. Or not even, like the first season
except
of The Office.
Except for Ron Swanson.
Ron Swanson's not even like Ron Swanson in the first season.
Yeah, not
like,
yet.
They still hadn't figured him out.
Yeah, they didn't know who he was just yet.
They hadn't turned him into like this, then turned
cultural
him into
icon.
The like neo-libertarian anarchist that he became. At that point, he just was like very apathetic, or he's like
right.
Lethargic. I always get those mixed up. He's very lethargic.
Yeah, he's a great character, but he only gets better.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Same with like Tom. They hadn't taken Tom to his like extreme.
Yeah.
Yet, so he's just like very calm. And then when they finally take him into that, like, Entertainment 720 thing, it's like, that's what he... There you go.
Entertainment 720!
When dreams come, they come true.
Every time someone says they're the worst, Lee's like, they are the worst!
The worst! He's the worst.
He's the worst. Funny.
Oh,
whenever I hear that, I think of Britta.
Well, that show. Okay, that show did not turn out well.
Who?
Community. That show had really strong seasons. That show had a few really strong seasons, and then it fell to shit. So. I watched every episode.
And then didn't Yahoo like have it?
Yep. One season. I'll still if they do a movie, I'll still watch it. But man, did that show kind of fall apart. It was
I don't know. I never started it. So I
It was
I have
really
to know.
Strong for the first couple seasons and then they fired Dan Harmon. And
then brought in the people who did Aliens in America,
and then
they just aped off that.
Fuck is that?
That was a CW show that had the kid from Cougar Town.
Anytime you say CW, I immediately my brain turns off. So
that's deja vu, actually.
The only CW show
I think I'm gonna die
that
soon.
I cared even a little bit about was like Buffy, and we didn't even finish because Nicole got to that really famous like sexist episode, and it made her so angry she stopped watching.
Which episode?
There's an episode in like the 5th season where like that guy Riley goes away, and it's like
Mark
Blucas kind of sexist, huh?
Mark Blucas.
Yeah, nobody likes that fucking guy.
Yeah.
And,
why? How is it sexist? I haven't watched Buffy. Look, okay, Buffy's a good show, but I get really tired of it really quickly, so I haven't watched it in years.
It's sexist because I think, like, from what I remember, I didn't see the episode, but I've had it described to me multiple times, but, like, the guy is, he's, like, all brooding, and he's, like, he's just really, he's a horrible character. And I don't mean horrible like he's done horrible shit. He's horrible because he's poorly written.
Right.
And he's just supposed to be this, like, manly man. and he's really boring. And then at some point, he's just like, he like cheats on her, and then he's like, well, you wouldn't give me, like, you can't give me what I want and all these things. And then he's like, goes to leave, and then they like basically blame Buffy for it.
You're like, and they're like, how dare you drive away that
like a man and all this stuff. Yeah, it's
how dare you drive away that guy though none of us really liked.
And it stands out like a sore thumb in a show that's like pretty fucking progressive. It's like right. All of a sudden,
right?
There's this fucking weird episode. Yeah, it like annoyed the shit out of her, and she's like, I can't watch this anymore. She never finished, but like everyone keeps telling her like the rest of it's really good though, and I have to agree, like. That show is kind of cheesy when it starts, but then as it goes, you're like, this is surprisingly good. And it's like imagine, I heard it described once in a really good way. It's like, imagine like a high school drama. Imagine like all the things you go through in high school and going into college and dealing with parents, except it has super, like, except that it's told through metaphor in supernatural monster stories.
Yeah,
like imagine that. So like imagine like dealing with your parents' divorce, but it has some kind of like something about ghosts, and it's not technically about that, but like the underlying theme is that that's what it's about, you know? Or it's like
right.
Somebody has a mental illness, but the mental illness is like actually, you know, they're part like demon or something, or like part vampire, and they can't deal with that fact. They have like a lot of anxiety and stuff, so it's like the character deals with like it's really interesting actually. Like when you get down to it, you're like, this show is kinda like really ahead of its time. And then yeah, there's that one episode.
You know what I don't here's the thing about Joss Whedon is that he irritates me sometimes.
Did you just call him Josh Whedon?
No, I called him Joss Whedon. You just can't. I can't hear me. Sometimes he irritates me with the names that he uses. Like he's trying to be obvious. Like when Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. started, they introduced this character who's an orphan, and her name is Sky. I'm like, well, you know, she's important. You know why? Because her name is Sky. You know? Yeah. And like, I'm like, there's another character whose name is Melinda May, and I'm like, nobody names their names anyone Melinda May. Nobody's named May, honestly, from what I know. I've never met anybody whose surname was May.
Well, I mean, that doesn't mean that that kind of shit doesn't exist. People have a lot of, like, I've met people that have, like, really old-sounding names, or just have, like, I met someone named Minerva the other day, and I'm like, really?
Minerva?
Yeah.
Did you know that Minerva is Minnie Mouse's full name?
No.
I knew this because my kid is a big fan of Minnie Mouse. And I was curious one day. I was like, what is Minnie short for? And lo and behold,
Minerva Mouse.
Minerva Mouse.
That's funny.
I wonder if...
I'm not up on my Disney lore, so...
I wonder if Mickey, his full name is Michael. Michael Mouse.
His name was almost...
My kid just goes, Michael Mouse? Like, you dumb asshole.
I don't remember what his name almost was.
I know Oswald.
I know it wasn't
the Lucky Rabbit.
I know it wasn't Oswald, because Oswald was a thing before Mickey
Mouse.
Oswald
was like his predecessor, right?
Yeah. I gotta know now. It's gonna drive me crazy.
Look it up. That's what we'll end on, because I think we're almost. I think we've gone over a little bit.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Let's see.
But
take a look.
Oh, his name was almost Mortimer.
Mortimer.
Yeah.
Mortimer Mouse
before Disney's wife Lillian told him that he needed to change it because that's awful.
Have you watched Rick and Morty at all?
Only the first episode.
Did I show it to you, or did I show it? I showed it to Allan, and he didn't like it.
It's like, not Alan's humor.
No, it's not. I thought he might like it, but
Allan has a very specific. He likes awkward and really inappropriate humor. Like that's, and Rick and Morty is like a little more ridiculous. I tend to fall in like I love things that are fucking ridiculous, which is why I like in American Dad, I love Roger because like fucking everything he does makes no fucking sense. Like there's that beginning of the episode where it starts off and the whole family's on the couch and like it just starts with him wandering into the house and he's drunk and he's wearing like this Mexican outfit with like a huge mustache and just like blah, blah, and like that to me is ridiculous because it's like there's no fucking context for like what's happening.
Yeah.
It doesn't need any. Like it's just, you know.
Right.
That's the kind of shit another good example is like Patton Oswalt's bit about like who do you talk to about pussy and he's like, "Well, he's like Nana stopped reading my emails and the police took away that fuck doll I made out of butter and shotgun shells." So nobody. Like that kind of shit is what makes me laugh cuz it's like doesn't make any sense, but it's like comes out. It just comes out like it's normal.
Yeah.
I like that kind of stuff. But yeah, Allan falls into the like dick poop jokes, but also shit that's like incredibly awkward for everyone.
Right.
So Rick and Morty's probably not the show he would enjoy.
I like Rick and Morty. It's it also gets dark sometimes.
Oh, I'm sure.
And I like that. Yeah.
I like that a lot. I like that.
Like when they had to kill. Oh, and there's an episode, spoilers, where they have to kill themselves because they fucked up. They fucked up their universe so badly that they found that they had to find a separate universe that was almost that was probably at least like 99.9% the same as theirs, killed their doppelgangers and took their place. And like, and they're playing this great and this song, it's called Look On Down from the Bridge by Mazzy Star, and it's dark and like it's such a dark song, and it's played over like Morty, like this horrified Morty like burying his own body in their backyard.
Like, see, that's funny.
It's so fucked up, but I was like, it's God, ridiculous. That's amazing. Like, it's...
But yeah, that's another thing I find really funny is when something incredibly dark is happening, but it's like lightened up by like background music or something.
Like when the lady paints a little girl in blackface.
Like, like if it had been that if it had been a scene of like Morty murdering himself, but it's just playing doo wop zip a dap a dap doo wop, I would think that was fucking hilarious. Because it's like the contrast is so like apparent and absurd that it's funny.
There was I like that I brought it back to fucking Daniel Tiger.
This is not Tiger-tastic.
You know, it's not always about you.
It's an animated version of you is the final episode.
You know, I always thought would have been the best.
You're like, I think I have to sue somebody for using my likeness.
You know what I always thought would have been the best final episode?
The most controversial children's show ever aired.
The most controversial, like, series finale of all time would have been Murder, She Wrote. Should have been Murder, She Wrote. Because, like, this woman is an author who just happens to solve murder mysteries. And they happen every time she's around. Like, she's, like, fucking, like, going on book tours and shit. And every place she stops, murders happen.
And I
Yeah,
just
and then she's like,
wanted.
well, I better go solve this. It's like, are you even qualified?
I just wanted, like, the last episode to be like, I'm a serial murderer. I've been killing all these people. Like, that's in the first 10 minutes, and then the next hour and a half is just a big long car chase.
It's just like
OJ Simpson.
I was gonna say it'd be funny if it was just like the last episode is the first episode of like Law and Order. It's like oh my god, that's so funny. Yeah, because it's like, what are the fucking odds? At least in X Files, it's like something happens and then they go there. It's like, it's not like, you know, which I need to watch the new episodes. I hear they're really good and I haven't watched any of
Oh
them.
my God, Rhys Darby plays an awesome character in the third episode.
Oh, yeah.
I hear it's good. I've
I
never actually
really
watched
hate the
it, though.
last season of X Files, so I'm hoping this kind of retcons some of that.
So.
Because, and I'm not alone, most people do not like the last season of X Files. But that you should watch it. It's super, like, X Files is super good.
I know, I've meant to
So,
watch it for years.
it's really entertaining. Like,
At
it's
some
like
point, I will.
take a show about like take a normal like FBI show with like a man and a woman, but then make one of them a crazy person who is addicted to porn, and then the other one is a skeptic.
So David Duchovny.
A
I mean,
skeptic Catholic,
because
yes,
he
yeah.
is.
Take David Duchovny and then a skeptic Catholic, which is already a paradox in itself, and make them go investigate alien abductions and like Bruce Campbell is Satan and all kinds of shit. There is an episode where Bruce Campbell is the biggest Satan. It's really good.
Yeah.
I've got to watch this episode now.
The last episodes of
It's
Mad
really
Men
good.
are finally up on Netflix. I can't wait to watch them.
No fucking way.
Yeah.
Really? Oh my
Last
god.
Friday.
Well, sorry, Clone Wars. I've got to finish Mad Men.
What's wrong? Tom?
No,
Ducky?
I'll finish Clone Wars. I'm like season four,
Better Call
and
Saul's up there
there's
now, too.
six seasons. I don't care, honestly.
I'll watch it. I like the guy
I
that
just
voiced
don't
Trevor.
care. I'm like Breaking Bad happened. Let it go.
Yeah, but Saul Goodman was a cool character.
He was, but I'm like, I feel like we had a good amount of him. Like, it was fine. I don't know.
I'd watch it. Have you watched any of Fargo?
No, but I want to. I love
The
that
first
movie.
season, is on Hulu, and it's so
Oh,
good.
yeah. Isn't it like a Showtime show?
It's FX. Oh, but
Oh, it's
it's
FX.
so
Okay. Oh,
dark
yeah.
and it's
Fucking
so
FX
fucked
and their.
up.
FX, like, needs to put their shit on Hulu, because it's fucking annoying.
Yeah, they put it up, but you might as well just watch it on Netflix because it just goes up the same day as Netflix does.
Oh, so Fargo's gonna be on Netflix.
Fargo's not on Netflix. It's the only one that's not, but like The League and Always Sunny always show up on Hulu the same day that it shows up on Netflix.
Oh.
So.
They want to be really protective of Fargo, apparently.
Yeah.
But
But
everyone's
Far.
telling
Oh,
me, like, oh,
man.
it's the best show on TV right now.
Billy Bob Thornton is. I mean, usually all the time, but he's genuinely terrifying in this show.
Usually all the time. That's funny.
He's
Yeah,
like
I love the
terrifying
Fargo
but funny
movie.
at the same time. Like he when he checks in, like he always goes for the weirdest thing. Like he's checking into a hotel.
Hello?
Oh shoot.
You cut out. He's like, he's checking into a hotel, and then there's a bunch of silence, and then you just giggled.
Yeah.
Yeah, one of
I was
my
like,
friends.
what?
One of my
Oh,
friends
okay.
is actually like listening, and he like texted me in Grand Theft Auto. He's like, "Your mic quality is terrible," which is funny because it's a
Yeah.
PlayStation Gold headset. Here's the
It's
problem.
probably because of your connection.
Here's the problem. Okay, it's a wireless headset, and because I have a 2-year-old. Yes, you are messy because you spilled milk on yourself. Yes. Because I have a 2-year-old who likes to grab stuff, I have to put my my PlayStation, where the wireless headset is plugged in, to like the little USB stick is plugged in, behind a metal grating in the TV stand. Okay, we'll clean up. Okay. But anyway, it's about time. It's about time to go. It's been a while.
Felt like I just got here.
I know. That's how this show works.
Well, you know.
You feel like you just got here, and then you're like, oh, it's over. All right. Didn't even talk about video games. Just talking about all kinds of shit.
Don't have to. Don't
we
have to.
We could have, though. That's we could have. That's the...
Well, thing. Is there something you want to talk about?
We could have talked about Watch Dogs 2 getting revealed.
Oh,
we
is it?
We could have talked about fucking...
Let's hope it's better.
All the Destiny news that happened yesterday, but no. We're just like, let's talk about other shit. Yeah, Watch Dogs 2 is coming out next year, but they didn't show it.
Look, I'll give Watch Dogs one more game.
I just don't care. I don't care.
I'll give Watch Dogs one more game, and if it sucks, then I'm done.
Ubisoft has betrayed me a lot lately.
Yes.
Like, I just can't. Like, Division was not, like, at least the beta did not impress me. And then the fucking Watch Dogs sucked. Assassin's Creed Syndicate was pretty good, but it was, like, more of the same. So it's like, if you gave me another one of those, I don't know that I would be happy with it. I think this is, like, the last straw where I'm, like, okay with it. But it's not coming out this year, so hopefully the one that's coming out next year is, like, fucking bonkers. So.
The.
She's like, die in a fire. I'm like, whoa.
My outfit is changing. My outfit is changing. She's naming all the colors.
Oh.
My outfit's being changed by the guy that's actually watching, so he's probably hearing that.
Oh.
It is a sweater.
Whoa. Oh my god, whoa.
Anyway. That's gonna be it for this week on Party Chat.
Oh no.
Why nay?
We play on PlayStation, so if you wanted to play with us, I'm Mattman310. Josh is PacPunk, that's PACPONK. Allan is that Jew boy, that's Jew boy BOI. Oh, changed my outfit again. Grandma? Look at them kicks. Or if you want to tweet at us, Mattman07. The Jawa Josh and the Allan Muir, AllanMuir. And that's going to do it for Party Chat this week. We'll see you again next week.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh my god.
Get me some sleep.